So let us continue. So when we say that we have measured kinetics, the unknown system with which we started, whenever kinetics is known, we now say that the system is known. The system is completely known. The precaution that we need to take, we have now completely understood how to get M, how to get N, how to get KMN, how to get activation energy, and how to write overall rate of reaction if any one or two are controlling overall rate. So that we know how to calculate. But one very important precaution we need to take is in a reactor, the partial pressure changes from inlet to outlet. This is the discussion with which I started with chapter 2. Suppose you take oxidation of sodium sulfide, right? And this example I am going to cover in great detail. Design 6, 7, 8 reactors in the class and show that which reactor is a good reactor at the end of it. And within that also there is a room for optimization after selecting one reactor. So I'll cover in great detail. I wish to cover all Thursdays and Fridays in the month of March. So stirred cell is known. The cross-sectional area is interfacial area. And now let us see what are the other designs which are possible. So this model contactor is called rotating drum. Anyway, I'll tell you the design and send these slides to you. Imagine a cylinder which is rotating, and partly it is dipped in the liquid and partly it is open to gas, right? So whenever cylinder rotates, it picks up some quantity of liquid in the form of a film over the cylinder. So the cylinder area which is exposed to gas and which picks up the film, and when the rotation is complete, all that is liquid is again deposited back to the bulk. So interfacial area is known, and by changing the cylinder speed, we can change KL. So both the requirements, that interfacial area is known and there is a possibility of changing KL, this is satisfied, right? This is one. Then the second one, array, you can show in this manner also, they will understand. The second one is called wetted wall column, wetted wall column. So what is done is, what I'll do, not only I'll give you the drawings, but I'll send you the descriptions also and the entire methodology, okay? But qualitatively I'm describing. Imagine a rod or imagine a pipe, a hollow pipe. The liquid is introduced from the bottom, and when it comes at the top, it overflows the top end and falls like a film on the outside of the cylinder. Correct. And this is enclosed in another cylinder where gas somewhere enters and leaves. So the cylinder area pi dl is the known area, and by changing the liquid flow rate or by changing the film velocity, downward velocity, we can change KL. So that is another model. Are you with me? Yeah. The third one is called, the name is laminar jet.
No, wetted sphere.
You have already very good.
Wetted sphere.
Yeah.
Wetted sphere.
So this is one more. Wetted sphere means there is a certain way to introduce liquid from the top, and then that liquid spreads throughout the sphere. Like from here, the liquid is coming. At least once it should come. It's okay. That's okay. So sphere is wetted, and the liquid flowing like a film, it comes down and there is another sphere, the another film is formed. Likewise, there are 3, 4, or 5 spheres in series, and that is called wetted sphere column. And with the assembly of spheres is accommodated again in another cylinder, there is gas inlet, gas outlet. The point is, sphere area is known, so known interfacial area, and the mass transfer coefficient can be varied by changing the speed. The laminar jet, imagine a pipe, or the whatever liquid outlet you have in the household. So you open the tap and a jet comes out, right? And when the jet comes down, you design a pipe in such a way that all the liquid is collected by that pipe. Can you at least imagine? Right. So this is called laminar jet. So the introduction of liquid by a pipe and pickup of liquid by another pipe, in between whatever piedial area, that is a known area, and by changing the liquid flow rate, we can change the KL, and the equipment is called laminar jet apparatus. So I described to you rotating cylinder, I described to you wetted wall, I described to you wetted sphere, I described to you laminar jet apparatus, right? I'll give you the, generally have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Right, so now I'll give you the description. Fortunately, whatever discussion we have done up till now does not change if the multiphase system is different, right? For example, if you take liquid, all right? So these two liquids are immiscible, and again imagine stirred cell, there is an interface, and both the phases are agitated separately by separate impellers. The drive is also different, and one drive is from the bottom, one drive is from the top, but we agitate or move both the impellers in such a way that the interface is at least visibly flat, right? So that then it satisfies the condition of non-interfacial area. Now, if it is liquid, the only requirement as compared to gas phase, additional information which is required, is we need to know in which liquid, whether the reaction is happening in light liquid or heavy liquid. In gas liquid reaction, usually the reaction happens in the liquid phase. There are very, very few cases where reaction also happens in the gas phase. Such complex case I am going to cover in the class, but these are maybe 5%, not more than that. But in liquid, it can happen in heavy phase or in the light phase. So we need to recognize to begin with in which phase the reaction occurs. Normally I discuss this in the class, that is ask the opinions how to vary the variables, whether we can change the relative liquid levels or whether we can change the relative impeller speeds or do something, temperature, something by which we can. When I was teaching in 1972, one who was giving good answer, I was giving a prize of 1 rupee, to which I increased it to 500 rupees last year. But I don't have time this time. And I will not increase also because of that, the money. But I don't mind the asking your opinion. There's a lot of learning in that. But when I came prepared for teaching you today, I have decided myself to explain it to you right from the beginning. That is, what do you prefer? Silence means I should explain to you. Yeah. I'll explain.
Sir, it is connected.
It is connected, so the same thing, no? So as designed, it shows there is a liquid film, but there is a certain hardware here because of which the film is not exposed in this portion. The gas is only here. The point is this curved surface multiplied by length of the cylinder is the known interfacial area, right? Next. So this is the wetted wall column. Liquid goes inside through hollow pipe. When it comes at the top, it overflows and it comes down. So this is a film of the liquid. This is a gas. And then liquid finally enters into a pool of liquid at the bottom. Then there is a gas inlet, gas outlet, the other provisions are there. Next slide. So this is wetted sphere. The liquid falls on the sphere and all are supported by a rod. Liquid flows like a film on the next sphere and the next sphere, and finally it is collected in the pipe. Next. This is the laminar jet. The one pipe makes it a jet and the another pipe picks it up. And this area is exposed area, which is pi dl, is the interfacial area, and mass transfer coefficient is varied by changing the flow rate. Next. This is equipment is used only for very slow or slow reactions where there is no need for knowing interfacial area. That is, if you keep on increasing impeller speed and there is a heavy dispersion and you can keep on increasing KLA 5 times, 10 times, 50 times till it becomes impeller speed independent, and you bring it positively in regime 1 and try to get the kinetics. But this is useful only for between 1 and 2, between 1 and 2. Next. Yeah, okay. So that is, I had a few contactors for solid liquid or solid gas reactions. Anyway, we'll take up that next time. So I was describing to you or explaining it to you the need before we go further in which phase the reaction occurs. Correct, no? So suppose at the beginning we really don't know. We really don't know. If we analyze both the phases, let the reaction happen in any phase, whatever is the reactant is going to get consumed, right? And the reactants are in both the phases. So you keep on analyzing, that is not going to tell us in which phase reaction is happening. If you analyze the product, say for example, right? So the product is formed in a phase in which reaction is occurring. But if it is soluble in the other phase, then we again don't know whether in which reaction. But if you analyze the product phase in both the phases, you can only know overall rate of reaction. All right. So what are the other possibilities now? Now we know regime 1, regime 2, regime 3 and regime 4. If we change the relative proportions of two liquids, suppose two both together is 1 liter. Start from light 100 ml, heavy 900 ml, 200 ml, 800 ml. 300, 700, and up to 500, 500, and go on the reverse direction also. What will happen? If we now measure kilomoles per meter cube second and meter cube with respect to that particular liquid phase, right? If it is in first regime, and the rate is expressed with respect to volume of that particular phase. So epsilon L is 1 in that case, correct? So rate is independent of the relative proportions. Because it is kilomole per meter cube second, right? And if that is the case, and if the rate, overall rate is increasing with respect to level, then we can find out with respect to level of which phase the rate is increasing. And that will tell us the phase in which reaction is occurring. Understood? No. No. I am explaining now for a case where reaction is in regime 1. It is very slow and reaction controlled. All right. This is point number 1. Point number 2 is we are expressing the rate kilomoles per meter cube of individual phases, kilomole per meter cube second. So, epsilon L is 1. All right. So, Kmn star s to m, b naught s to m, which gives, we still do not know m and n, but it is giving only kilomoles per meter cube second. Now, you change, keep on changing relative proportions. Right. Then what will happen? The kilomoles per meter cube second multiplied by volume of those individual phases. Now, instead of kilomoles per meter cube second, you now plot kilomoles per second with respect to liquid level. The phase in which the reaction is occurring, when we increase the volume of that phase, then the only that rate will increase. If it is happening in the other phase where level is decreasing, then the kilomoles per second will keep on reducing. Understood? Now imagine it is in the second regime. Now you will also answer, there is an impeller on this side, there is an impeller on the other side. You keep one stationary, you keep on rotating the other one, right? So if you keep on changing the relative proportions, then you can come to know which one is rate controlling. If it is in regime 3, by changing the total quantity, the interfacial area changes. Right. And the interfacial area, in all our discussions we have already decided interfacial area is to be expressed per unit volume of dispersion. But just for the purpose of finding the kinetics, let us express it as interfacial area per unit volume of individual phases. Right. So, what is the interfacial area is cross-sectional area, that does not change. As we increase the volume of heavy phase, interfacial area meter square per meter cube decreases and meter square per meter cube of light phase increases as we raise the interface level above and change the individual proportions of both the phases. So, we now know the direction of changing interfacial area, we can calculate the overall rate in kilomoles per second and plot it with respect to liquid level, we'll come to know in which phase it is occurring. Have you understood?
Yes.
Right. Now, again, as a homework, it is not mandatory that both should happen in regime 1. One can happen in regime 1, another can happen in regime 4. Under those conditions, what is to be done? Do homework. One who gives very satisfactory answer, instead of 500 rupees last time, I'll give 550 this year. Okay. If I get very good answer, then I carry 2000 rupee notes also. I carry. I must get excellent answer. Huh? Excellent answer. I should have today, no? No, I will not open. Okay, understood? So you think yourself. Now after doing that, what is the difference between gas liquid and liquid? Carry out the reaction. If it takes few hours to several hours, it is very slow. If it takes several minutes, it is in regime 1. Right. If it takes few minutes to several seconds, it is fast. If it takes very few seconds, it is instantaneous. Right. Now, call one as A, call another as B, make another table, call as one as A star, call one as B naught, find the dependence of A star, find the dependence of B naught, find the dependence of impeller speed in each phase. So, you have KL dependence, you have epsilon L dependence, you have A star dependence, you have B naught dependence, you have interfacial area dependence, and knowing all these, you can bring any liquid-liquid reaction either in regime 2 or regime 4 and try to get M and N, try to get KMN for liquid-liquid reaction and try to satisfy then later on whether root M is greater than 5, less than 1, whether it is in the first regime, then that condition should get satisfied. Then always we can keep on increasing impeller speed so that with lot of confirmation we can positively bring it in regime 1 or if required in regime 3. Take solid liquid reactions. The positive part of solid liquid reaction is solid surface area is always known. So, we do not need any model contactor, right. So, you take say known number of particles, I have not brought the model contactors for solid liquid anyway, I will bring it next time, but qualitatively I will describe it to you. To an impeller, you attach a basket at the bottom and in which you keep bunch of particles inside, known particles with narrow range. Right. Call it as instead of A and B, call it C if you wish, solid now, and you rotate now. So, there are how many possibilities? Solid reacts with dissolution. So, if there is a, you can remove this. Now, there is a lot of space here. So, if I show solid surface like this, and there is a liquid film, and call this as C, and saturation concentration, saturation solubility of solid is say C star. And if it is flat and let B not be the liquid phase, call it as regime 1, C star C naught is equal to 0 and C star call it as regime 2. And once you draw these concentration profiles, writing the corresponding rate equations, what is exactly? Replace C star replace S star by C star, you will get exactly the same equations, right. And in a basket, if you have put say 50 particles where interfacial area is known, and by changing the basket speed, we can change the mass transfer coefficient, and then in that manner, we can change C star, we can change B naught, and again make a big table. The dependence on C star, dependence on B naught, dependence on impeller speed, dependence on interfacial area, dependence on, now instead of epsilon L, you can keep epsilon L or you can make it epsilon S, right, both are possible. Right? And then how to begin? Again find out whether several hours are required, several minutes are required, several seconds are required or few seconds are required. So, you know order of magnitude. From that, you want to bring it either in the first regime or third regime. So, you typically know whether you should bring it to first or third. If you want to bring it to the first, keep on increasing the impeller speed so that the mass transfer coefficient between solid and liquid now keeps on increasing. So, that now instead of KLA, it will be K solid liquid mass transfer coefficient, KSLA can increase with speed and take it to very high value. Indirectly, you can take smaller particles so that interfacial area increases and try to make KSLAP so high that it becomes reaction controlled. Once it becomes reaction controlled, you can of course measure the kinetics. If you are in the third regime now, that you can do, you now know the enhancement factor root m, how to play with the help of KSL now. Value of KSL, value of B naught, value of C star, keep on changing so that, but that those definitions of root m, I could have written here A only, why I should write C? The same equations will hold exactly. Understood? So by analyzing one system in great detail, one modification though happens, that imagine this to be a solid surface, there are another types of reactions where that is B naught is here and here the B is 0, then there is a possibility of like this also. And instantaneous reaction, it is something similar. So some possibilities of like this can occur that we need to understand whether it is of this type or whether it is of this type. Simple answer is whenever there is a nice finite solubility, it happens like this. When there is a very poor solubility of solid phase into liquid phase, it happens like this. I may repeat this, the same portion, the liquid-liquid and solid-liquid, when we meet next time. Next week, being a Science Day week, I'm moving in Kolhapur and Sangli district and giving lectures on science and technology to the farmers. Not only that, I'm explaining them what are the possible technologies for you by which lot of value addition is happening, is possible, right? Our per capita income of our nation, I must have told you, is 1 lakh rupees. But village people is less than 30,000, right? And whatever they do, they increase the productivity, then also they are poor. They reduce the productivity, then also they are poor. Productivity increases, nobody takes it, because the number of mouths in the country, that doesn't change with respect to productivity. So increase the productivity, the rates fall down. So under these conditions, what is to be done? What are the ways of value addition? There are fruits, jackfruits, I told you last time, 80% are lost. The fruits, the cashew nut fruits, 100% are lost. Are you from anybody cashew nut area? Raise your hand. Pomegranate, anybody from that area? Are you? Any one fruit, banana? Are you not even one banana? Which one?
Orange,
yeah. So you come from Nagpur area? Nagpur area? Good. But if you see what is the income per year, how many trees are there per, and how much we are dependent on the nature, right? And this is very fearful situation. And if we are claiming that we are expert in science and technology, and if we are not helping 70-80% of the masses, then something should happen in that direction. So I'll spend next week there. So therefore, 1 week we will not meet the next week. So I'm going to take good number of examples. That is the only thing remaining. That is, having understood how to write overall rate of reaction, how to write at every point within the reactor, how to integrate those rates in order to get overall performance and come back to the dimensions, that part I will teach.